I've been putting this video off for such a while. It's about the Whiteleys shopping centre in London. It used to be a department store and it really was all about glamorous, high society shopping. This is where you went in London in the 1860s. You know, it was here or Harrods. This was it. And all these old pictures on the support columns just shows you how grand it was back in the day. I'm going to stop talking now because this is the Toys R Us that is now closed down.
That's really sad.
Yeah, so Toys R Us has closed down now. I really do need to go back and see what this place is like now that a few more shops have closed down, because I filmed this way back in about December or January time and it's now July. So this is one of the main entrances and this gorgeous glass ceiling and all these fixtures and fittings. Now, this isn't entirely original. The shopping centre only opened in 1989. The building itself is older. But the building itself, in respect to the outside fascias and the inside railings and staircases, are original. Everything else is new. So all the shops, they was put in afterwards. The place was sort of gutted and then reopened as a shopping centre. It wasn't really popular though, because it's in a quite expensive area. And they filled it full of your general generic shops. So it was a bit derided by the high society of London that still exists today. They didn't really want to shop there. Now this used to be a Chinese food shop, which is long closed down. This place is almost, I'd say, 90% closed down. There's very little left. Now you'll see me constantly panning to the floor, not just because the floor is gorgeous, but there was still a few security guards, you know, and they was looking at me. And this is actually the top floor, which is closed. This is now a TV studio on the third floor, so you can't go up there. That is also just recently closed down, so the entire top floor now is vacant. But then nearly every floor is. I was talking about the floor because I kept having to pan down. This is the second time I went back. Later on in the video, you'll see the first time I was there. I wasn't brave enough the first time I went in, but this time that I'm doing it now, I've actually got the camcorder blatantly in my hands recording what is going on. And the security guards didn't actually care. I think because they're losing their jobs, I don't think they care. Look at this gorgeous floor and them stairs. And this is the only place to eat. It's Pizza Express. That is all that's left open. And that's the Odeon Pictures, which is a major place left open. This is more of the ceiling in the other parts of the... This is like the older part of the shopping centre. There's Odeon again. It wasn't lit at all, and this was much more in the middle of the day. It's really quiet in there. Look at that old thing, escalator there, which shows you how old it is. And these escalators were so loud and rickety, but only because there was no other noise. Apart from the odd clitter-clatter of maybe the odd lady wearing high heels on the marble floors and stairs, the only noise you could hear was the traffic outside and the clatter of the escalators and the odd screaming kid, obviously, which would really reverberate and echo around the entire shopping centre. Some of these shops, I have no idea what they used to be because they've done a really good job at tearing everything out. But some shops from the outside, you get an idea what they used to be. Just coming up, there's Gap with the 70% off. It's one of the few Gap shops remaining in the UK. And there's more of these support columns with pictures on of the former grandeur of the place. As I come down the escalator again, I'm just trying to remember what I saw now. Oh, there's Marks and Spencer's Simply Food. That's closing down as well. I think it's still open now, but it's been earmarked to close because Max and Spencer's are closing down loads of stores. That's another closed store. That's London Gale, which is like ladies' knickknacks and stuff. That's Musk and Nail Bar there, which is like a bit of a mainstay for failing shopping centres and high streets in the UK. I've seen them a lot, but mainly in glum areas. Look at these gorgeous stairs. And they're all marble. They're all original from 1860s. And this is all going to be hidden away. This is why I wanted to do this video, because all this is going to be hidden away behind luxury apartments and an hotel that they're building. Now, this Zara on your left, that's still open. But this bit I'm walking down now, everything is closed. And it used to be like a bar and restaurant area. Now, I've been loads of times to this shopping centre, especially when Toys R Us was still open. And this bit is really, really quiet. And sometimes it's mainly just staff from the recording studios, the production company upstairs, come down to this bit. But now they've gone, when I go back, hopefully it's still open. I have no idea if it's closed or not. These are more empty units that have been closed a very long time. You can really tell because there's all grub up against the windows and dust. Now this is the actual stairs that you're going to see now. And they're so old that the edges of the stairs have worn away so smoothly. And they've got a lovely curve on them. And all these railings are really old. And you can really tell the difference, can't you? Between original old and stuff that's made to look old. I mean, look at that cornicing and decoration. You just will never see that ever again in a shopping centre. We'll never get to see anywhere as grand as a destination of this. And this is the problem with retail. This shopping centre is unfortunately in the wrong place at the wrong time. This sort of look and atmosphere is what would really work to keep retail going as a destination. Now, you just saw a bit of Sports Direct there. That's the only shop that's not earmarked to close. But the actual shopping centre is going to close down at the end of 2018. So I've only got a couple of months left. There's Toys R Us still open. These gorgeous windows in a shopping centre. You don't really see windows in a shopping centre, do you? Because usually it's just shop to shop to shop. This is the directory of the shopping centre. Empty. A fake closing down shop. That shop's always in there. And it's always saying it's closing down. I've got to say though, of all the shopping centres to get its own TV series, I can't believe it went to Selfridges. Because Whiteley's, I mean, the owner of it, he started really from very little, and then he made this grand department store, absolutely huge, and it's where everyone wanted to go, and he got shot by his illegitimate son. The dramatise of that, you know what I mean? You could really dramatise that into an amazing TV show. This clearly used to be a Hollister or something. I mean, look at that fake roof sort of thing going on. That's the only thing I can think of it ever being. Unless it was some fancy restaurant, I don't know. No, I can't believe there's no drama series or film made about William Whiteley. Because it was definitely a ladies' man. Loads of stuff going on there and him getting shot by his legitimate son, you know. It's all there. And the rise and fall of the department store and then turn it into a shopping centre and never picking up. There's so much story there that could be made. These are some old quotes that were made from back in the day when it used to be a department store. So, for instance, in the restaurant, they used to serve swan. You could actually eat swan back in the day. Now, not too sure what I think about eating a swan, but anyway. Yeah, that's one of his famous sayings. The department saw everything from a pin to an elephant. A bit of an exaggeration. But on the outside, as you can see, this was clearly filmed when we had all the snow. And yeah, look, this is the middle of the day, look. It's only 10 to 4 when I recorded that. And look how quiet it was. Bear in mind, this is Queensway and Bayswater in central London. And look how quiet it was. It's really dead in there. It's really sad that all this building is going to be locked away now behind private property doors. And an hotel. We're never going to see this ever again. On the window there was a directory of stores that are inside, but most of them have closed down now. Now, this is a blue bum. No, this was the first time I went in. Now, this is actually quite much later on a Sunday. It's 6:30 on a Sunday, so most of the stores are shut because in the UK we have Sunday trading laws, which means that stores have to shut at a certain time and they're only allowed to be open certain hours. So in this view, most of the shops are closed. This is an empty shop, and as you can see, this was on this one, it's really weird because they're not boarded up the glass, so you can actually see through to the street, which I thought was really weird. And there's another empty shop. Do I stick my camera up against the glass? Yes, I did. You can see it's a bit grubby, that one. Look, that one's been closed a long, long time. The next shop, this one that I'm just breezing by, that clearly used to be a body shop because it's Body Shop Green. Their branding green colour. That shop's still open, but it's just closed because it's late. So there was the only two shops on that side, I think, that are closed. I think I pan up to the ceiling now, very quickly. I'm much more nervous on this shot. Because I'm scared that a security guard's going to tap me on the shoulder and tell me to get out and I'm not allowed to film. And, yeah. You can tell now as well that the camera's quite low down because I've actually got it in my camera bag with the front unzipped and I'm carrying it. And so this is about knee level. So it's really low down. You get a better look at the stairs here. In the dark, this place is really quite creepy because it's so echoey. This place would be great to film a horror film in. And if you need to use a shopping centre, this will be a great place to go. The time that's left. And I just can't get over the quality of the workmanship went into this. I mean, shopping centres, when they're open today, everything is simplicity and utility. That's a bit of foreshadowing. Look, Toys R Us closed, but not closed down yet. I don't know if it's still there, but they had a cardboard cutout of Jeffrey the giraffe, like a 7-8 foot giraffe inside there that they've left in even though it's closed down. And it looks really sad. Sad as in sad, not sad as in stupid sad. Because I can't believe no one took it. They could have given it to a nursery or something to put on the wall. This is more hot floor action. And railing action. Yeah, the Gap, which I'm just passing there. I think that was Gap. Was it Gap? Am I outside of the shopping centre? No, I'm not. That was something else entirely. I think that was H&M. Yeah, H&M. That's what that one is. That's still open. And there's Sports Direct next door to Toys R Us. And look, in the dark, this place is just so dark. At night time, I mean. Yeah, this is 6:30 on a Sunday, so everything is closed in here, whether it's closed down or not. So this is really creepy. This is a bit like foreshadowing of what is to come of this shopping centre. And it would, no one can save it now. So no one could come in now and say, do you know what? You're not going to turn it into apartments. You're not going to turn it into an hotel. The reason why it still won't work is because it's in completely the wrong place now. This entire building would need to be lifted out of its foundations and plonked somewhere else because you've got Westfield Shopping Centre, Europe's biggest shopping centre, just 30 minutes away on the bus. So they've built a massive shopping centre just 30 minutes away from this. And I love Westfield Shopping Centre very much, but the building quality of it is nothing like this. It is quite simplicity and utility, Westfield Shopping Centre, with the exception of the roof, which looks pretty nice, but it's still nothing even close to this. See, this has been used as some sort of storage area, that shop. And I did used to have better pictures of these support beams with all them pictures on, and I really do need to update this video already. I am going to do a newer version of it, and I hope that you'll watch that too. What made me do this video is because I've been watching a lot of the failing shopping centres in the US. There's loads of them in America, but not many in the UK, because in the UK, we don't really have many shopping centres. We have high streets, but they're suffering the same as well. And it's not just because of the internet, and it's not just because people's shopping habits have changed and everything, but there's other reasons as well. You know, private equity firms just buying companies and investing nothing. running them into the ground. That's affecting shops, causing them to close down. And daft prices as well, obviously, and lack of convenience, and shops just generally not being a destination. This is weird because this shopping centre is a destination, but with no shops in it. It really is unique in that sense. So this is the Odeon again, still deathly quiet. The only thing I can think of is that these shops have been given an amazing rent to stay open, just to keep it viable, to keep it going until it is eventually closed down and turned into apartments and an hotel. I'm quite interested to know what they're going to keep as the hotel and what they're going to board up and keep out of public view as apartments. I just don't know. Look at more closed down shops. And there's pictures on there of shops that it thinks... Yeah, there's the Body Shop logo up there. That's long gone. And the tyre rack went bust ages ago. And so many of them shops have gone. They've not even bothered to keep it updated. I think if they did, though, I think they'd run out of the point of doing it. So the H&M's still open. That Nan West, I don't know what that is. That's gone. The Pizza Express is still open. Le Café is gone, I think. The Odeon's still open. Doom's gone. Jigsaw's gone. They've all gone into Westfield. I moved to London a few years after Westfield opened. So I can only imagine that as soon as Westfield opened, all those shops just instantly closed down. I've forgotten what this orange box thing is. I've forgotten what these are. And the way I'm watching this now, I'm not too sure what it says. But I hope you've just seen what it says. I'm not too sure if it's something to do with parking at the back. There didn't seem to be a lot of parking. I did have another video on this, but I seem to have lost it. And it was the car park area, but it was tiny. Not a lot of parking here at all, which is obviously another terrible thing for a shopping centre. It needs parking. And of course, with all the charges and with the excess traffic and the charges on charges as well, just to drive through London, most people don't drive anymore. And this shopping centre is close to tube stations, but not close enough. Westfield has actually got 3 tube stations on its doorstep. This shopping centre has got none. It's a bit of a walk down a street where you'd probably get soaking wet in the rain if it rained. Or snow. Like, because it was snowing when I did these. I think we're coming up to the end of the video now, aren't I? Because it's on 18 minutes. And... stuck behind 2 people again. I seem to be back at Toys R Us again. I think I'm just on my way out now. I think I'll go down the stairs and out at this point to show you what it looks like. So there was a security guard right there. And I have one last look up at this gorgeous glass ceiling and railings. This is all the main entrance bit. I love this bit. I'm going to really miss this. And in a way, I'm really sorry that I didn't get to see this when it was fully open. I don't even know if it was ever fully open, if you know what I mean. I don't ever think that all the units was ever filled, since as soon as it opened, it was not appreciated by the people who lived around there. Yeah, I think I'm on my way out now. It won't be too long. I think I'll go another walk on that quiet bit again, don't I? So there's me. You've probably seen me that... And this is obviously the Sunday, but in the previous video, you probably saw my awful yellow top. So I wasn't very bothered the second time I was filming in there. I wasn't too bothered about being seen to the point where I was actually wearing a fluorescent yellow coat. But this time I was really scared. I was like in a black coat and I was carrying a bag and I was really conscious not to stay still too long because I thought I might be looking suspicious, which is the last thing you want to do in London is look suspicious. Now, this is the Zara shop that's still open. But obviously, at this time, it's closed on a Sunday. And it's just so many echoes. And there's no music playing in this shopping centre. They don't pay for music. So that's... I don't know if that was ever a thing. There might have never been music in here. There also used to be a water fountain when it first opened. But apparently, that closed and got removed unceremoniously as well. It was just there 1 minute, gone the next. And this is it, really. That's my video using the new microphone, so I hope this sounded all right. And this is my video on the Whiteley Shopping Centre that opened in 1989, but the building itself is from the 1860s. I'm going to go back and hopefully do some better filming of the shopping centre to give you a better idea what it looks like. I'm going to slow down because I feel like I'm moving around too fast as well. But in the meantime, thanks for watching. Please scrass, which means subscribe, comment, rate and share. Thanks for watching. Bye.